Your basic proportionality theorem statement is, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio, which is the statement of Thales' theorem. Thales is a great mathematician. Here, for this statement, first we want to draw figure. First we want to draw a triangle. Therefore, I am drawing triangle ABC. ABC is the triangle. Here, in this triangle, I am considering BC as the side. For this side, drawing a parallel line, which is parallel to BC. Here, D is the parallel. This parallel line intersecting AB at D, AC at E. Here D and E are the two distinct intersecting points. Okay. Here I am writing. From this statement we will write given. Given triangle is ABC, that is written. DE, which is parallel to BC, also given in our statements. That is also drawn and here under given written. Here finally in this theorem we have to prove this parallel line intersecting AB, AC at two distinct points D and E such that AD by DB and AE by EC, that is writing under RTP, AD by DB is equals to AE by EC, which is required to prove finally. To this proof, we will do some extra work, that is known as construction. Under construction, join B and E, C and D. Similarly, draw perpendiculars from D and E as DM and EN. Here, DM is perpendicular to AC, EN is perpendicular to AB. Here, both perpendiculars drawn, which is the construction. That is writing, join BE, CD, drawn perpendiculars DM and EN. Now by using this statement, now important step writing, that is proof. Okay, for this proof, to prove AD by DB is equals to AE by EC, first I am finding area of triangle ADE. Area of triangle ADE. Here, area of triangle formula is half base into height. Half base into height. Half. Just I am drawing triangle AD here. For our convenience, I am drawing triangle ADE. To find out the area of this, we have to know about height. Height base required. First, I am considering in this triangle ADE, EN as height. Suppose EN be the height. Now AD becomes the base. Okay, by using this, we can write half base as AD, height as EN. Therefore, this is the area of ADE. Now, just area of ADE found. Here see, we have a triangle BDE. Now, I am finding area of BDE. Area of triangle BDE. For our convenience, I am drawing BDE here like this. B, D, E. Now, here area of this triangle is required. Area of triangle formula is half base into height. Half, we don't know about base. We don't know about height. To find out base and height, I am extending. Already we have this figure. In this figure, I am separately drawing. From E, EN drawn.
which is perpendicular. Therefore, here EN is the perpendicular extended to BD line. Therefore, here BD becomes the base, EN becomes the height. By using this base, this height, we can write here half base as BD. BD may be written as DB. Height means EN. Similarly, find out the area of ADE. Area of triangle ADE. For our convenience, I am taking this type of ADE. ADE. Previously here EN perpendicular considered. In this, I am considering DM perpendicular. In this ADE, I am considering this perpendicular, that is DM. Now, area of this triangle is half, base is AE, height is DM. Now, we have another triangle, that is CDE. Find out the area of this CDE. Area of triangle CDE. Half, for our convenience, I am taking this type of triangle. CDE. Here already CE extended. Already drawn DM as perpendicular. Now CE becomes the CE or EC. DM as perpendicular. Now find out the ratio of these two. Now area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE. Here area of triangle ADE is half AD into EN. Half AD into EN. Area of triangle BDE is half DB into EN. Here EN, EN, half, half will be cancelled. You will get AD by DB. Suppose this is the first equation. Similarly, find out the ratio of these two. Area of triangle ADE by area of triangle CDE. Area of ADE is half AE into DM. Area of this is half EC into DM. DM, DM, half, half will be vanished, cancelled. AE by EC. Suppose this is the second equation. But from our figure, we can write here this is the triangle which is BDE. This is another triangle, CDE. Here BDE triangle and CDE triangle lying on the same base. Means these two triangles constructed upon same base. And these two triangles lying between same parallel lines. This triangle and this triangle constructed upon same base and lying between two parallel lines. Therefore, they have the equal area. Therefore, by this statement, we can write area of BDE is equals to, we know that area of triangle BDE is equals to area of triangle C, D, E. Now, from first and second equations, I am considering left hand sides. I am considering left hand side of first equation. Area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE. Area of triangle ADE writing as it is, but area of triangle BDE is equals to what? Area of triangle CDE. According to this statement, both are equal. Same written numerator, but BD, area of BD is equals to area of CD. But according to first equation, area of AD by BD is equal to AD by DB. AD by DB. Area of triangle AD by CD from second equation is AE by EC. AE by EC. Therefore, AD by DB is equals to AE by EC. Here, which is the RTP, which is required to prove. Finally, we have to prove AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Finally, we got AD by DB is equals to AE by EC. Therefore, this is the proof of basic proportionality theorem. This is the proof of Thales theorem. Therefore, these are the diagrammatical explanation here given. Clearly drawn diagrams here, which is the explanation. Therefore, from this finally we can conclude that RTP proved here. Therefore, which is the